Hello, my younglings. Are Tasmanian devils really greedy little gobblers, or are they not? Today we're traveling back to Australia, as requested by a young girl named Susan, who loves watching them in cartoons, and saw my previous episode about Australia. She says I forgot the devils. Oh, I didn't forget them. There are just so many fascinating things over there. It's like a whole continent full of wonders. Did you know that Australia is home to the dingo? The dingo is a type of wild dog. The name dingo is also used for wild dogs in Malaysia, Thailand, the Philippines, and Papua New Guinea. In Australia, dingoes are mainly found in the western and central parts of the country, near water sources. The Australian dingo is very similar to a domestic dog. It has short, soft fur, a bushy tail, and upright ears. Their coat color ranges from yellowish to reddish-brown, often with white markings on the underside of their body, paws, and the tip of their tail. They rarely bark, but they have a variety of howling sounds, which is why these animals are sometimes called dogs who sing. They feed on other animals, and in the past, they primarily hunted smaller kangaroos and wallabies. With the arrival of Europeans and the introduction of rabbits, their prey became rabbits and small rodents. Sometimes, they attack livestock, which is why farmers consider them pests. But we've talked about this before. They're just surviving. They're not pests. And did you know that lions live not only on land, but also in the sea? What? You don't believe me? Then you probably haven't heard of the sea lion, which I'll tell you about after we learn a bit about some unusual plants you can only find in Australia. For example, the telepias are spectacular garden plants. In fact, they're so striking that they almost beat the golden wattle to become Australia's national symbol back in the early 1900s. Telepias have red flowers. They bloom in spring and attract various types of birds. Five species of telepias can also be found in yellow or pink, and in rare cases, white. Telepias are an important food source for nectar-feeding animals, like honey possums and pygmy possums. They are known for being hardy plants in their natural habitat, even surviving bushfires. The telepia flower is rich in vitamins and carbohydrates. Dodonea is a shrub-like plant that can be found all across Australia. In the 19th century, it was used to make beer instead of hops. Some Aboriginal groups used dodonea as an analgesic and to treat skin inflammations caused by rashes and bruises. Stings from jellyfish, rays, and stonefish could be soothed by applying poultices made from crushed leaves of this plant. Dodonea is especially valued by beekeepers for the beautiful honey produced by bees from its flowers. Mmm, I really love honey. Australian native grevilleas, also known as spider flowers, include over 300 species. Their colorful and unique flowers don't have petals, but consist of long tubular parts called perianth, which divide into four branches. Grevilleas are older than dinosaurs. They originated on the supercontinent Gondwana a long, long time ago. Grevillea flowers are known for their sweet nectar. Some indigenous Australians mix this nectar with water to make a tasty drink. However, caution is needed. Not all grevillea flowers are safe to eat. Some flowers, like those of the silk oak, can cause allergic reactions leading to contact dermatitis. The chemical is similar to the toxic compound found in poison ivy. Some species or cultivars of grevillea contain toxic nectar with cyanide. The silk oak is the tallest grevillea, growing up to 30 meters high with spectacular golden flowers in the spring. Birds, butterflies, bees, and other nectar-feeding animals are drawn to grevilleas when they are in bloom. Now let me tell you, Tasmanian devils really eat anything they can get their paws on. These little creatures have quite a big appetite for food. Tasmanian devils are also known for their loud screaming and growling, which is so scary that early European settlers, thinking they heard demons or devils, gave them the name devils. These sounds, which include coughing, grunting, and sneezing, help scare off other animals. Although they are small, a Tasmanian devil's bite is so strong that it can break bones. In fact, Tasmanian devils have the strongest bite relative to their size of any mammal. They sometimes even chew through metal fences and cages to get to livestock. Like all marsupials, Tasmanian devils store fat in their tails, which get thicker when the animal has enough nutrients. A thick tail is a sign of health for a devil, and since they can eat up to 40% of their body weight in a single day, their tails can get really big. Tasmanian devils have a strange habit of sleeping inside the remains of their prey. This way, they can keep eating as soon as they wake up. Although it sounds morbid, this behavior actually helps keep the ecosystem clean by removing leftovers that could attract worms and other pests. A Tasmanian devil newborn is the size of a grain of rice. Oh, so tiny. Its mom must have to watch over it with a magnifying glass. Forest humor. The female can give birth to 20 to 40 babies who compete to reach her pouch, which only has 4 teats. Those that make it stay in the pouch for about 3 months before starting to venture out and explore the world. This challenging start to life is part of their natural cycle. No wonder they're so greedy later on if their life starts out like this. The Tasmanian devil is the largest carnivore among marsupials, and its diet consists entirely of meat, including birds, snakes, and other mammals. It uses its powerful jaws to crush and eat even bones, as well as the remains of dead animals. Tasmanian devils are very shy and usually pose no threat to humans unless they feel threatened or trapped. However, when they feel endangered, they start yawning to show their sharp teeth in an attempt to scare off potential predators. Younger Tasmanian devils are more agile than older ones, and they can even climb trees. This helps them escape from adults, who may sometimes eat younger devils if they're very hungry. Tasmanian devils are also excellent swimmers, and can run at speeds of up to 15 miles per hour for up to an hour. So here's another animal ready for the Olympics in all disciplines. Tasmanian devils have been an endangered species since 2008. The main causes of death are traffic accidents as they try to scavenge dead animals from the road. The number of Tasmanian devils is increasing again on the Australian mainland, thanks to a special program that helps them live in a safer environment. What? A lion? Oh, right. I need to tell you about sea lions. They are mammals that mostly live in the waters of the Pacific. They are a type of seal. The name sea lion comes from the fact that most males have a mane, just like male lions on land. Also, the males need to roar to defend the females in their group. There are 5 species of sea lions: California, Northern, Southern, Australian, and New Zealand. California sea lions are known for their intelligence and memory and are often trained for performances in zoos. When they're not in the open sea, sea lions often stay on isolated rocky islands, peaceful coves, and coastal beaches. Sea lions range in color from golden brown to dark brown, but they often appear darker when wet. They have short noses, small tails, excellent vision, short, rough fur, and small ears. Sea lions eat fish, mollusks, and crustaceans, and some even eat penguins. Sea lions are similar to walruses. Both can turn their back flippers forward under their bodies when on land. When threatened, sea lions can bite an enemy with their sharp teeth, lunge at them, or dive and escape. There you go. And flying squirrels are little furry creatures that fit right into the palm of your hand. Flying squirrels are nocturnal animals that love to have fun, but they're not actually real squirrels. They just have that name. But don't tell them that. They'll get upset. Although they resemble squirrels, besides flying, they differ by having longer, more flexible tails, bigger eyes, and toes that are better adapted for gripping tree trunks. Flying squirrels prefer life along the coast. Their natural habitats are tropical and temperate forests in Australia, Indonesia, and Papua New Guinea. Their average living space is around 16 square feet, which is like a very tiny storage room, and it depends on the availability of food. Though they're small, flying squirrels can bark very loudly, almost like dogs. Imagine that. A dog barks at you, but you can't even see where it is. Turns out it's a flying squirrel. Since they're nocturnal, they can be a bit demanding as pets. Their nighttime activity can disturb peaceful sleep, so owners might face some noisy surroundings. If you decide to keep them as pets, get ready for some real fun. Pygmy possums are small animals that belong to the marsupial group, and their family is called Burrhemidae. They are nocturnal creatures and omnivores. Their diet consists of invertebrates, fruits, seeds, nectar, and pollen. They're excellent climbers thanks to their flexible tails, which they can wrap around tree branches to hold on. Although they can't glide like some possums, some species can jump long distances. While their tails are perfect for gripping branches, they spend most of their time on the ground. The mountain pygmy possum is the only mammal restricted to the alpine and subalpine regions of mainland Australia. They were thought to be extinct until they were rediscovered in 1966 on Mount Shigenbotham in Victoria. They are the only Australian marsupials that hibernate. Since they live in a very cold climate, they store energy in fat deposits before curling up like a ball to regulate their body temperature during the winter months. Interesting little animals are also wombats. Wombats are marsupials, and female wombats have their pouches facing backwards. Baby wombats are born without fur, weighing about 1 ounce and measuring less than an inch long, like tiny violet flowers. Their fur starts growing only at around 4 to 5 months of age, and they stay in their mother's pouch until they're about 10 months old. Wombats are close relatives of koalas. Today's wombats are the closest surviving relatives of the Diprotodon, giant marsupials weighing over 3 tons, which were part of Australia's megafauna. Imagine that. They had famous ancestors who were huge, but those big animals went extinct, mostly because there's much less food for them now. But remember when we said that horses, through evolution, became bigger and that their ancestors were small like dogs? Wombats have reinforced rear ends thanks to a tough plate of cartilage that protects them from predators. They are herbivores, with grasses making up the main part of their diet. Their teeth grow continuously, and their poop comes out in the shape of cubes. Is that even possible? Cubes? Oh boy, I hope they don't know about the video game Minecraft. Cube poops. Wombats are burrowing animals that dig large tunnels, and several wombats can live in the same burrow. Some burrows have multiple entrances and can be very long. They appear in many cartoons, and believe it or not, one version of a wombat mascot was even banned from the Olympics. You humans sure are imaginative. Australia's home to a lot of poisonous animals, like many venomous snakes, whose bites can be very dangerous to humans and animals, sometimes even deadly. I mean, it's my job to tell you they exist, but we can talk more about that when you're a little older. Not everything is meant for my stories, right? That's why you have your parents, to learn from them what's dangerous and what's not in the area where you live. For example, in one forest, mushrooms are inedible, but on another meadow, mushrooms that look exactly the same are edible. So listen to your parents when they warn you about something. They do it because they love you, right? That's all for today, friends. In the next episode, we'll be talking about a very interesting topic, and in the meantime, write to me about what else you'd like to talk about. And if you want to learn more about this fascinating topic, don't forget to subscribe. Yours truly, Troll Mitros. Naturally,